Developing this morning, China pulling the broadcast of the Boston Celtics season opening game after center Enes Kanter criticized Beijing for its treatment of Tibet and called President Xi a dictator. David Culver live in Shanghai this morning. And David, you know, you covered the last near schism between the NBA and China in 2019. There's a difference in how Chinese officials and state media are handling it this time. What are you noticing now?
There really is, John, and as you well know, criticism does not go over well here. And generally, there is what they have self-described to be a wolf warrior approach. That's an aggressive counterattack to any sort of critique, especially of the leadership. But this time, yeah, they're going a different way. And you can't help but think that while they're still using this more subtle censorship, they're doing it a bit quieter. And this perhaps is how they're going to react to the outspoken athletes that come here for the Olympics. Chinese basketball fans logging on to watch Sunday night's Boston Celtics game, seen black. The team's past games also pulled from the video site of Chinese tech giant Tencent, which paid $1.5 billion to stream NBA games in China. A swift censorship following star player Enes Kanter's blunt criticisms of the most powerful Chinese leader in decades and his policies.
Brutal dictator of China, Xi Jinping, I have a message for you and your henchmen.
Kanter first calling for freedom for the people of Tibet, an internationally recognized autonomous region within the People's Republic of China.
The Chinese dictatorship is erasing Tibetan identity and culture.
Then doubling down over the weekend, the Muslim athlete calling out China on another human rights matter.
All of us must spread the word and call on the Chinese government for free the Uyghur people.
CNN's covered extensively allegations of widespread abuse targeting the Uyghurs and other Muslim minorities living in China's far western Xinjiang region. Beijing has called its actions counter-terrorism against Islamic extremists. Kanter, who hails from Turkey, echoed the U.S. and other countries, labeling it as genocide. Inevitably, nationalistic backlash followed, with social media posts within China slamming Kanter and the Celtics, reminiscent of the 2019 controversy sparked by the then general manager of the Houston Rockets, who tweeted his support of pro-democracy protest in Hong Kong. That, in turn, led to a temporary pullout of sponsors and partners and a blackout of NBA games in China, costing the league hundreds of millions of dollars, according to league leadership. The NBA has not commented on this latest incident, but it's yet another reminder for multinational businesses. The lucrative Chinese market is now a minefield with increasingly nationalistic Chinese consumers. A Chinese foreign ministry spokesperson said Kanter was trying to get attention and that his remarks were not worth refuting.
But instead of attacking Kanter aggressively and putting on the full court press in state media, like we saw during the Houston Rockets controversy, Chinese authorities are going with a different play, quietly censoring mentions of this latest episode online and trying to move on.
As athletes from all over the globe prepare to descend on China for the Winter Olympics in a little over 3 months, some of them may call out Beijing on a range of issues, from Xinjiang to Tibet to Hong Kong to Taiwan. China's more muted response to Kanter so far, perhaps an indication that officials know all too well the whole world is closely watching how they handle the fallout when sports and politics clash. And no doubt, John, the world will be watching very closely for the upcoming Olympics. And you can't help but think that there are going to be a lot of criticisms. You have a range of issues that folks are going to talk about. And there have been calls for boycott, but there are some groups saying, no, don't boycott it. Use that to raise awareness. How China responds, it may be strategic in that they don't really react at all. Hope that it passes and people move on.
David Culver, that's a fascinating report. I hadn't thought to connect the reaction to Enes Kanter to the Olympics, but it's an astute observation there and maybe a sign of what is to come. Thank you so much for that.